The NBC2 investigators have been combing through Desmaret's criminal history. We found it's hard to separate that history with his mental health issues.
Tonight, investigator Rachel Polansky explains how we got here.
In the months leading up to Wisner Desmaret's supervised release, he sent two handwritten letters to Sarasota Judge Stephen Walker. In May, he told the judge that he is, quote, always worrying about people trying to kill me, and some of those people are supposed to be serving and protecting me. And in June, he talked about his, quote, paranoia problems and seeing different colors on the wall. But the NBC2 investigators have learned that Desmaret has a long history of mental health issues.
Wisner Desmaret, case number 15CF.
In a 2011 burglary case, a Lee County judge deemed him incompetent to stand trial, but restorable. So he was sent to the Lee County Jail to receive mental health treatment for more than a year.
I think I'm left with no conclusion except to find that he is incompetent to proceed.
And in a 2016 burglary case, a Lee County judge again deemed him incompetent to stand trial, but this time the judge said he was non-restorable, meaning no amount of medication or therapy could make him competent.
Based upon the evidence that's been presented to make those findings and to, dismiss without prejudice.
A few months later, Desmaret was arrested again for cocaine possession in Sarasota County. This time he was deemed incompetent but restorable. So he was sent to a state hospital where he received mental health treatment until a doctor deemed him competent. And he was sent back to Sarasota where a judge released him under pretrial supervision.
Is it unusual for someone to be deemed non-restorable and then a few months later or a few years later to be deemed restorable?
It does seem perhaps a little odd that somebody is not restorable in one case and then only, you know, a short time later is deemed to be restorable.
So the NBC2 investigators asked psychologist Dr. Eddie Renier why a judge would release someone with mental health issues.
We used to be able to put him in a group home somewhere. We had a case manager who helped him. Those services are pretty much gone. So for that small range of severely mental disorder people that really they need care for the rest of their lives, the only resource we have these days is prison.
And attorney Peter Dennis agrees, telling me there are few mental health resources available for those living in Southwest Florida.
We don't have long-term facilities in this state that are really set up to help people who may be non-restorable, especially if they haven't been found guilty of a crime.
And the mental health resources that we do have continue facing budget cuts. Just last year, Salus Care, Southwest Florida's most comprehensive provider of mental health care, got hit with a $750,000 cut in state funding. And Florida ranks 49th in per capita spending for mental health care. For the NBC2 investigators, I'm Rachel Polansky.